And now, this is the Italian hammer thrower, Orlando, as the hammer throw competition is underway. His first throw was 236 feet, and that one is out around the 245-foot mark. Giampaolo Orlando of Italy. There is one American, Bill Green, in the hammer throw final. Crowd loves to watch this. Normally, they relegate the hammer throws, if you attend track meets, to some auxiliary field. Very few people watch, but here they are in full view of close to 90,000.
They're showing up. Cut up.
And Orlando's last throw is 245 feet, 6 inches. And that's good enough to move him at the moment into second place, back of Klaus Proghaus of West Germany. And there he is. His first throw was 247 feet, 8 inches. His second throw, 246 feet, around a 249-foot throw for Klaus Proghaus of West Germany. There was a great story in the hammer, of course, the fact that Ed Burke, at the age of 44, had even made the American team after retiring, after not really even thinking about the hammer throw. But unfortunately, the Cinderella story for Burke ended yesterday with his failure to qualify for the final. But it's in Olympic Games, obviously, that Burke will never forget, in as much as in the opening ceremony, he was chosen as the flag bearer for the United States contingent. There's the mark for Proghaus's throw, 249 feet, 2 inches. Our live coverage continuing from the Coliseum, and we'll be back. Whether you finish first or fourth, the key is to finish in the top four. Now, this took place just moments ago. Bill Green, the only American who qualified for the hammer throw, who was seventh after two throws. You need to finish in the top eight to get three more throws. This was his third throw. He's from Sunnyvale, California. We mentioned before, Ed Burke did not qualify. Green, the American record holder, coming in, getting set here for his third throw. And it was a beauty.
There's been a rebirth in American hammer throwing in this last year. The American record switching hands a couple of times, and now Bill Green has it once again.
Throw by Green was good enough to move him into fourth place. That is where he is right now, 245 feet, 3 inches. The leader is Tianen of Finland at 256 feet, 2 inches. But Green is in good shape right now to receive three more throws, as the top eight of the 12 who qualify for the final will get three more throws apiece.
Well, Green's a big man, and Americans have realized that you don't have to be big to throw the hammer, but it's really the speed that counts. So he's got both things going for him, the speed and the strength, and he knows it's a good one.
So Green with an American record, he's in contention for a medal. Two Americans have advanced. So with Cameron. Meanwhile, a look at the hammer throw. Karl-Hans Riem of West Germany is ready for his fourth throw. He is in second place in the competition, trailing Tianen of Finland. 256-2 is the leader. Bill Green, the only American in the hammer throw final at 245-3, a new American record, in fifth place. So the man in second right now, Riem of West Germany. And that one hits the cage. So the screen is set up, obviously, to protect the fan. You occasionally do see the hammer thrown errantly, and as we mentioned before, it's normally an event that's relegated to some outside field, but it's their day in the sun, Dwight Stones, here in the Coliseum before almost 90,000.
Well, the hammer throw is, like you said, it's a very dangerous event, and they had some problems qualifying yesterday with the hammer cage collapsing. It's a very tightly packed group right now. In fact, Bill Green, 245-3, is just under the new American record that he set just recently of 251, and if he got a throw in that area, he could get into the medal scheme. So he has two more throws. He has looked strong on a couple throws this afternoon, and I think with the right attitude and the right feel and relaxation that Bill Green could pop one and get into the medals.
Right, his record that he recently set is a pending one right now. He's in decent shape right now in the hammer throw as that continues. A look around the packed Coliseum. Okay, Jack, a lot of action here. The hammer throw winding down, and you have Karl-Hans Rehm, the final thrower in the competition. As you can see, Dwight Stones, 255-10. He's in second place right now, but he can win the gold with a good one here.
This is a great position for Karl-Hans Rehm. He's a seasoned competitor. He has the one final throw. He's 4 inches behind the leader. If I am Tianen right now, I am shaking in my boots because Rehm has had a lot of throws in excess of what the current leader has thrown. If Rehm can just get it together and focus all of his attention on transferring the velocity to the end of that hammer, this could be the gold medal performance right here.
He needs it out near that third and final white line, and, well, I don't think he did it. In fact, he fouled.
He fouled. Well, it was a foul on the circle, and it doesn't look like it was long enough to make take over the lead anyway. So Finland's Tianen, who I think it had to be the favorite coming into this particular competition, has held up to win the gold medal, and Rehm settles for the silver.
256-2 for the Finnish hammer thrower. Right now, let's go to Donna DeVerona.